In this practice, we will learn to work in a sterile field condition in order to preserve sterility of the pharmaceutical forms for preparation to administration to patients. Certain pharmaceutical preparations, medical and useful instruments to be in contact with the skin wounds or internal organs need to be sterile. In particular, certain routes of administration, for example, parenteral or ophthalmic route, are susceptible to be contaminated that may lead to infections which are very difficult to treat. Therefore, dosage form for these routes must maintain the condition of sterility since packed until administered to the patient. In the lectures, we study various methods of sterilization and which are the key parameters to correctly adjust the conditions of an sterilization cycle. In many cases, the dosage forms, as dispensed, are not the final dosage form, and it is necessary to perform different operations such as reconstitution of lyophilized site powder or make an appropriate dilution to obtain the final dosage form. It is critical that these operations are carried out so that the sterility of the product is preserved. To do so, rooms or cabins for working in a sterile field are used with certain precautions to guarantee the lowest possible contamination of the final dosage form. In our case, as common in pharmacy services, we use biological safety hoods, type 2. These hoods protect the user, the environment, and the product. As explained in the lectures, these hoods are characterized by generating a laminar airflow which prevents the deposition of pathogens and other particles on the preparations. This air is sterilized by using a HEPA filter, resulting in a high-quality air-free of particles greater than 5 microns per cubic meter and less than 1 colony-forming unit per cubic meter. Furthermore, these cabins are equipped with an ultraviolet light to avoid contamination when the airflow is not activated. Very importantly, to ensure sterility within the hood, we have to use sterile products and items, for example, operator gloves, to avoid contamination into the hood. To do this, we must use a spray of ethanol at 70% concentration to clean the surfaces prior to being introduced in the hood. There are several important considerations when using a laminar flow hood. All tools or preparations introduced in the laminar flow hood should be sterile and should be cleaned superficially with an aerosol of 70% ethanol. At the beginning and at the end of the use of the laminar flow hood, wash the surface of the hood. They may be cleaned with 70% ethanol or with other products designed for it. At the beginning of its use, turn on the airflow and shut off the UV light to prevent injury to the operator. At the end of its use, shut down the airflow and shut on the UV lamp. When manipulating the tools inside the laminar flow hood, do not interrupt the laminar air flow over surfaces in contact with the pharmaceutical preparation, for example, the tip of the syringe needle or the cap of a vial. Design a dirty area where dispose the tools that have been already used to avoid cross-contamination. And finally, manipulation of the tools has to be done preventing potential contamination by surface contact. In the video, you can see an example of preparation of a dosage form for injection from a concentrated solution. In the video, first of all, the operator used the autoclave in order to sterilize the saline. In this case, that's the vehicle for doing dilution. This saline needs to be transported to the laminar flow hood. All the items has to be sterile. We have to shut down the UV light and turn on the light and the fan of the ventilator. The products must be sterile, and we have to prepare all the setup of the products that we are going to be using. Before introducing any item into the flow hood, we need to spray it with 70% ethanol. We also must to clean the gloves of the operator before to introduce the hands into the laminar flow hood. It is important to prepare the vials that we are going to be using and the bottles that we are going to be using. To measure the volume of the concentrated solution, we will use a syringe. Other items to measure volume can be also used. It's important to displace any air bubble contained into the syringe. We will also attach a 22 micron filter to also do a sterile filtration. And it's important to fill the empty volume of the filter. And then after, select the appropriate volume. We will use sterile vials to perform the dilution. And we have to be careful at the moment of introducing the solutions to not to produce any contamination by contact of the surfaces. We will select the appropriate volume of the sterile solution, which is the vehicle for do the dilution, and make sure that we don't do cross-contamination. Appropriate volume will be measured and will be added on top of the other solution into the vial. And we must to be careful and not to avoid to cross and interrupt the airflow. At the end, we have to seal appropriately the vial.